Good that you're listening, that you're tuning in, and you're watching Children's Ministry. Let's do it. Let's get our Bibles where you have your Bible on, whether it's on your phone, whether it's on a tablet, and we're going to get into the Word of God for today. Heavenly Father, we come to thank you, to glorify you for this day, for this is the day that you have made, and we choose to rejoice and be glad in it. We thank you for this message that you're giving us. We thank you for your word that shall go forth, that we know, Lord, it will not return unto you void, but it shall accomplish all the things that you sent it to do, that it will prosper in the lives of those who hear it, Father God, that it will fall upon good grounds and produce the harvest. In your Son, Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. All right, faith kids, get your Bibles. I know you have them. Let's go to the book of John. In John, we know New Testament, and we're going to go to chapter 13. And on this week, faith kids, your memory verse is Luke chapter 1, verse 29. And I know last week that you meditated upon your memory verse that we had. And I know that the Holy Spirit revealed to you some great and awesome things through that word. So that's why we meditate on his word, so we can be all that he has called us to be. So in the memory verse this week, it says, look or behold. I like the word, the versions that says, behold, the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Again, Luke chapter 1, verse 29, behold the Lamb of God, or look, the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. That's your memory verse to meditate upon this week. Allow again the Holy Spirit to lead you on this verse. It is so awesome. Think about what it's saying. The Lamb of God. Who is the Lamb of God? We know it's Jesus. And it's so much that you can know through the scriptures and what God is saying, who Jesus is and what he's done. Amen. So study and meditate upon your scripture this week. And as we are in John chapter 13, we're going to read verses and start at verse number 1. But in this passage, we're going to be talking about, let me ask the question, faith kids, what are some things that you celebrate? What do we celebrate? We celebrate what? Birthdays, we celebrate anniversaries, we celebrate different holidays. We celebrate what? When we were saved, when we allowed Jesus to be Savior, to be Lord of our lives. We celebrate that. And we even celebrate when we're baptized. If you've been baptized, we celebrate those things. Our baptismal. Those are things that we celebrate. So we're going to be reading this passage, and they were celebrating things. And so we're going to be talking about the first communion. And I know we had communion service a couple of Sundays ago, and we do it every month, but we're going to just read in the Bible about the very first communion. So are you there in John chapter 13, verse 1? It says, before the Passover celebration, Jesus knew that his hour had come to leave this world and return to his Father. He had loved his disciples during his ministry on earth, and now he loved them to the very end. It was time for supper, and the devil had already prompted Judas, we know the story, son of Simon Iscariot, to betray Jesus. Jesus knew that the Father had given him all authority over everything, and that he had come from God and would return to God. So he got up from the table. This is Jesus. He got up from the table, took off his robe, wrapped a towel around his waist, and poured water into a basin. Then he began to wash the disciples' feet, drying them with the towel that he had around them. So Jesus was washing the feet of his disciples. Normally, because they didn't have cars and bus transportation and all of these things in those days, so they walked everywhere. So it was always dust from the walk on their feet. So when they went to someone's house, their feet was dusty. So the servants would come and wash the people's feet who came to the house to visit. So Jesus got up and he began to wash his disciples' feet. Let's read on. Verse number 6. When Jesus came to Simon Peter, Peter said to him, "Lord, are you going to wash my feet?" And Jesus replied, "You don't understand now what I am doing, but someday you will." "No," Peter protested, "you will never, ever wash my feet." Jesus replied, "Unless I wash your feet, you will not belong to me." So Peter is like, "Okay, God, you gonna wash my feet? And no, you're not gonna do that." And we might do that even now. Think about, because those people who we honor and who we esteem, and you know, like Pastor Stan said, "Okay, come here, I'm gonna wash your feet." You'd be like, "No, Pastor Stan, no, you don't have to wash my feet." So that's what Peter was like, "No, Jesus, it's okay. You don't need to wash my feet." But Jesus said, "If I don't do this, you don't have no part of me." So let's see what Peter went on to say. Okay. So I want to be in you, Jesus. I want all that you have for me. So Peter knew that his relationship with Jesus. So he said, "Okay, go ahead, Father. Not only wash my feet, you can just wash my whole body. You can wash my hair. Do it all. Since you're going to do it, just do everything." So of course, Jesus told Peter, "Okay, we don't have to go that far, Peter. You've already washed. We just need to do your feet. You don't have to do your whole body, because when you're clean, you don't have to go back." But I understand where Peter was going. If I'm going to be in Jesus, if I'm going to say I need all of him, I want all of him. So let's just do it all. I understand what he was doing. So let's continue to read. We're going to go over to a different scripture. Let's turn over to Matthew and go from his account. Matthew chapter 26. We're going to go there and pick it up in verse number 17. After Jesus has washing their feet. And so, let's go there. So in the scripture, as you're in Matthew chapter 26, so the scripture that Jesus washing their feet, and we know that we talked about the lesson about who's the greatest, and Jesus says those who are servants is the greatest. So that's what Jesus was trying to tell them, that you have to be a servant. You have to do and be an example. We're to follow Jesus. So what are we to do? We're to be servants, whether that's washing someone's feet, washing their car, cleaning their house, or helping them cross the street, or whatever we can do to help someone else. We're to serve them. Hand them a paper, a pencil, pen, whatever we need to do, Faith Kids. That's what he's telling us, that we're to be servants. We're to follow after him. Nothing was too little for him. He just went, put his towel around his feet. "I'm going to wash the disciples' feet." And I can imagine their journey from a long way, that their feet was dirty. But Jesus said, "It doesn't matter. I'm here to serve you." So no matter what we are, no matter where we are in life and what position or title we may hold, we are always servant, because Jesus is the great example to us that we're to serve others. So in Matthew chapter 26, remember I said we're going to talk about the communion and what we celebrate. So there in verse number 17, we pick it up in the book of Matthew. It says, "On the first day of the festival of the unleavened bread," this is what they're celebrating. They're doing the Passover. The Passover was them remembering what happened when they came across the Israelites, when they came from Pharaoh. Remember, Pharaoh didn't want to let his people go. God had Moses there, and they went through all the plagues, and then they came with the death angel. And so they would put blood on their doorposts, and that meant that the death angel would pass over them, and it would not harm them, and everyone in that house was saved, just like Jesus has done for us, right? So they were celebrating. They took this time to celebrate the Passover. So this is the time that they were in, celebration of the Passover. And we continue to read. And Jesus asked, "Where do you want us to prepare?" The disciples were asking Jesus, "Where do you want us to prepare the Passover meal for you?" "As you go into the city," he told them, "you will see a certain man. Tell him, 'The teacher says, my time has come, and I will eat the Passover meal with my disciples at your house.'" So the disciples did as Jesus told them. So when it was evening, Jesus sat down at the table with his 12 disciples. While they were eating, he said, "I tell you the truth, one of you will betray me." greatly distressed each one of them as, you know, if your parents say, you know, some one of y'all messed up. Is it me? Was it me? Was it me? So all the disciples is like, who is it, Jesus? Because he said, one of you going to betray me. So they're asking, is it me? Is it me? You know, who is it, Jesus? Who is it? He replied, one of you who've just eaten from the bowl with me will betray me. So as Pastor always tells us, we're going to go there in scripture and see. I like Mexican food. So chips and salsa and some queso. So I can just imagine that, you know, they were sitting there eating the Last Supper, had some little chips and salsa and little queso. So Jesus is reaching with his chip, dipping in the salsa or dipping in the queso. And at the same time, he says, the one who is dipping out of the bowl with me is the one who's betraying me. So I can see Jesus and Judas at the same time reaching for a chip or dipping in the same bowl of getting some queso, right? That's what he said. So then Judas even answered, is it me? Let's read. For the Son of Man must die, as the scriptures declared long ago. But how terrible it will be for the one who betrays him. It will be better for them if he had never been born. So Judas, the one who betrayed Jesus, Rabbi, am I the one? And Jesus said, you have said it. So in other words, okay, you said it, Judas. All right, so as they were eating, Jesus took some bread and blessed it, and he broke it in pieces and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this and eat it, for this is my body. So we're talking about the first communion. This was the first communion that Jesus sat down with the disciples and had communion. He took the bread, blessed it, and broke it, and he gave it to each one of his disciples. And he said, take this and eat. This is my body. And I can imagine the disciples, because we understand it, because we're here and Jesus has died and we have the word and we know what's going on. So we understand communion in that way. We understand that it's a representation of his body and what he did on the cross. But at that time, Jesus was there with them. He wasn't dead. And there he's saying, eat this, this is my body. God, Jesus, what are you talking about? We're to eat your body? I can imagine them. They were a little confused about, I don't know, because in those days they had cannibalism, that people were eating animals, and they were eating, some of them were eating their children. So they was like, okay, Jesus, you want us to eat your body. Okay. So I can imagine that as they was taking it, because they were obedient, so they was eating it real slow, like, okay, is this really your body? So let's read on. And so then he took a cup of wine and gave thanks to God for it, and he gave it to them and said, each of you drink from it, for this is my blood, which confirms the covenant between God and his people. It is poured out as a sacrifice for forgiveness of sins of many. Mark my words, I will not drink wine again until the day I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom. Then they sang a hymn and went out into the Mount of Olives. So Jesus said, okay, this is my body. Take this, the bread. He blessed it, gave it to him. All right, this is my body. Then he did the same thing with the cup of wine. And he says, take, drink, for this is my blood. This is the covenant that God has with his people. So in the first communion was with the disciples that Jesus had. And we know that we take communion today, because he says, as often as we do, do it in remembrance of him. What are we remembering? We're remembering that he did what? Died on the cross for our sins, that he washed our sins away. Remember, our memory verse says, the Son of God came to seek and save the lost. And then our other memory verse says that what? Behold, the Lamb of God. He has come to save us. So as we're entering into this season, that we're remembering when Jesus died on the cross, and not only that he died on the cross, but that he rose again. So we're leading up to the resurrection and what was going on the time before Jesus was crucified on the cross. So faith kids, I know you had a great word on today. It was a lot that we said. Remember, it's on YouTube. Play it back again and continue to listen. Continue to know what God is wanting you to know from the Word of God, and meditate each week on your memory verse day and night that God will speak to you through His Word. And I will see you next week, faith kids. Have a great week. Bye.